The Beastie Boys said it best.
You gotta fight for your right to party.
But what if you live in Iran? A country where dancing, drinking alcohol, or even touching a member of the opposite sex are illegal. Well, you take the party underground. Literally.
We're just a bunch of crazy kids playing in the undergrounds of Iran, in cockroach-infested basements.
They look like Brooklyn hipsters and sound like the Strokes.
There's a man with a gun who lives inside my
But Hypernova is an indie band from Iran's capital city, Tehran. Traveling over 6,000 miles to get here, they were supposed to showcase at South by Southwest.
I heard Kirsten Dunst came there and like went out with the singer of Razorlight. She was supposed to go out with me.
Because of visa issues, they're playing New York instead. It's the band's first gig in America, and for most of the guys, their very first time outside the Middle East.
It took us forever to get here, you know, to pass all the security clearances and the checks and being from Iran and all the axis of evil.
Iran aggressively pursues these weapons and exports terror, while an unelected few repress the Iranian people's hope for freedom.
Yeah, you know, it's really dangerous what we do back home. You know, we're literally, every show, you know, we play, we're putting our lives on the line, you know, so. It's intense, but that, you know, that sort of fear, you know, adds to the rush.
When will all this hatred end?
Iran is notorious for censorship. In 2005, Western music was banned from state-run TV and radio. So we took the guys on a walk through Times Square to find out how much they know about pop culture.
Good at this. I suck at this game. Both of us, we grew up with like a punk background, you know, the whole Ramones and NoFX. We really dig the whole indie rock thing too.
I love Casablanca.
Kings of Leon, the country rock band, the Strokes, Arctic Monkeys. I like play drummer. He has a good energy and hyper.
How do you find out about all of this music living in Iran? Well,
the internet, you know, is the best source of communication back home. Like MySpace was filtered in Iran. Like, but you know, kids find ways to connect, you know, and eventually download their songs or whatever it is they want.
While much of the internet has long been firewalled in Iran, as of 6 months ago, high-speed internet connections are also forbidden, thanks to President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, Iran's ultra-conservative leader.
Thank you, Mr. President, for everything you have done for us. I feel so safe, I feel so fine. This world of yours is so divine.
And no matter what anyone says, if kids in Iran want to rock, they find a way.
Rock and roll has no boundaries. You know, it doesn't matter if you're from New York or from Europe or from Africa. It doesn't matter where you're from. You know, as long as you enjoy one common thing, which is that music.
It's our last chance to stand up and
for the next month, Hypernova is touring the U.S., promoting their EP titled Who Says You Can't Rock in Iran.
Living in Iran and, you know, being discouraged all the time, either by your parents, you know, just normal people or the government or anyone, you know, they always try to put you down.
No one can ever tell us how, ever tell us how to live out.
We're just happy that we've made it this far. We already have a cool story to tell our kids one day. Yeah, we went to New York. You know, your dad's a rock star. You know, at least I want to be one, you know. We're not going to give up. We're not going to bow down to anyone. And we're going to just do what we love to do because we don't see any harm in what we're doing.
Follow your heart, follow your soul, follow your dreams.
Thanks for that. You guys are wonderful. Thank you.